Hey guys, guess what? I finally started fixing my wall. I don't know if you can see that, but it's Ask Alexandria, and that poster was from when Dennis was in there, and I was refusing to put it up because, no, I constantly had this plan of, you know what, I'm just gonna print up a picture of Danny's face and stick it over that. So I did that.
And miracles fill up the skies when we hold our handfuls of butterflies.
Hey, hey, it's Jake Gray, welcome to Wing It Wednesday. I'm sorry that this is a day late. There was a situation with the voting, and a bunch of things were tired because only like 2 people voted last week. And yeah, it was mostly going off carryover votes. So, but anyway, we got that sorted. So, this week's topic is things you should never say to anyone ever. So I have a few things and I'm probably going to talk about them a little bit. So, right, okay. First thing, don't tell someone that they are dumb or stupid, right? Really? I feel like that really shouldn't need to be said. Like, don't go around calling people stupid because no one's stupid, right? Everyone is a genius in their own way. But if you go around and you say, yo, you're stupid, it's just gonna push them down, and that's not nice. That's not nice. There is actually a quote that I really love. It says, everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. And that's a big thing, and that relates to high school a lot, because in high school you are constantly judged on things, and everyone has to do things the same way, but not everyone learns the same way. You know, schools have, you know, this one way of teaching, but there are, you know, multiple different ways of learning and putting that to practice, and different people understand things different ways. So everyone's forced to, you know, go with this way, but not everyone can understand it that way. And then everyone gets judged on their ability to do things that specific way, and that is how they get told, yo, you're one of the smart kids, you're one of the dumb kids, you're one of the average kids in the middle. You know, it's ridiculous, alright? No one's stupid, everyone's a genius, everyone is a genius in their own way. I honestly believe that everyone has something that they are good at and something that they can thrive in. Thrive, is that the word I'm looking for? Second thing is, don't tell people that their dreams are unrealistic, right? If you're gonna go up to someone and say, hey, so what are you thinking of doing when you leave school, like after school, with your life, your future, that kind of thing, and if they, you know, actually tell you and confide in you what they want to do, what their dreams and goals in life are, and then you turn around and say, no, that's stupid and unrealistic, you're never going to get there. If someone wants to do something that much, they can get there if they want to, right? If someone's dream is to be a doctor, right, they can work towards that and they can get that. If someone's dream is to be a musician or a writer or an artist, they can get there. If they work hard for it, if they work for it and do what they have to do to get there, they can get there. You know, if someone wants to be a teacher, they can do it. If they want to be a bus driver, then by all means, go be a bus driver, alright? Whatever your dreams are, I believe in you, and I believe that you can do those things. Whatever you want to do in life, you can do it. And don't let anyone tell you otherwise, because your dreams are perfectly valid. And, you know, whatever you end up doing, you're going to be amazing at it. Don't go up to people and say you're lazy if you don't know their background on things. You know, some people have... I know this gets brushed off a lot, but, you know, some people actually have learning disabilities. Some people have, you know, problems with their sleep where they can't get enough sleep, or they are constantly tired, or, you know, things like that are mental illnesses. Other illnesses, you know, people have things that contribute to how they operate and how they function, and some people simply cannot function in the same way that all of you can. And don't brush that off, alright? You don't just randomly call someone lazy. If they actually are, and you know their history, and you know, everything there is to know, you still probably shouldn't call them lazy. I mean, maybe give them a kick of the ass and say, yo, you can do this stuff, come on, we're gonna work towards it together, and we're gonna get you going, and then, you know, or maybe try and find out why they are not doing what they're doing, you know, maybe they're struggling, whatever. You don't know. Don't just go up to someone and be like, you're not doing this, you're lazy. Okay? Another thing, don't just walk up to someone and be like, yo, what's in your pants? In reference to, what gender are you? Because, first of all, genitals and gender are not the same thing. I feel like I say that so often, it's not even funny anymore. It's honestly tiring saying that so much, alright? Genitals and gender are not the same thing. Right, genitals and gender are not the same thing, and even if they were, it's none of your business to go up to someone and say, yo, what's in your pants? What parts do you have down there? That's none of your business, and it's frankly just generally quite a weird thing to say. Alright, I have a few things that are sort of linked together here. So, I'm gonna try and put them in an order that makes the most sense. So don't comment on things about people that they can't change easily, in a negative way. You know, don't go up to someone and talk badly about, like, the fact that they have to wear glasses or the fact that, you know, their height. Don't comment negatively on someone's height. You know, call them names, stuff like that. It's none of your business, and you're just trying to put people down. Why would you do that? Why would you want to make people feel bad about themselves when you can make them feel good about themselves? You know, your words have a lot of power, and some people don't seem to understand that. But, you know, some simple phrases can do so much, and they can do so much damage, but they can also do so much good, and they can change someone's life in drastic, drastic ways. You know, not everyone has perfectly straight teeth. I don't. We all know that. And there's nothing I can really do to change that. So don't comment on things that people can't change about themselves, right? People can't help the fact that they're short or that they're tall. People can't help the fact that, you know, their eyesight isn't completely perfect, or that their teeth aren't completely straight, you know. They just can't. And while we're talking about things that you shouldn't comment on that people can't change easily, don't comment on a person's weight or body shape. First of all, that's none of your business. As are a lot of the things that I have spoken about today. But commenting negatively on a person's body weight or shape can be seriously, seriously damaging. You know, same as going up to someone and saying, hey, you eat too much. I can understand that if you are in a medical position and it's for the person's health and safety and good. But if you're not in a medical position trying to help this person, you have no right or reason to go up to someone and say, you eat too much. There is no reason for that. Unless they are, like, having serious health issues because of the amount that they eat, there is no reason for it. And that can be seriously damaging to people. And it's just one of those things you should just never say. There are a few other points that I would love to throw in here, but this video has gotten quite a lot longer than I thought it would, and I'm thinking that I am going to do a separate version for LGBT related things. So thanks for watching this, guys. If you have anything else that you would like to add, drop a comment. Feel free to let me know if you agree or disagree with anything that I have said. Don't forget to go and vote for next week, and I will see you guys then. Stay awesome.